What's up? Hello. Hello, what's up? Hello. How are you doing? I'm making an animation. I'm filming a little video about it. This is gonna be the animation when you get courage. Your courage goes up. Epic animation. You're trying to make this just a really epic feeling. Kind of like when you get the sword. It's just like overly epic, gratuitous animation and stuff. So it's kind of that. I got the little prototype there. I'm gonna work on the actual pixel art. Let's see that again. work on the pixel art for it so that it. Whoops. Oh shit, I saved it. Anyways, that's what I'm doing. Hope you enjoy watching this. Hey. Let's do this a little bit. 10. Alright, we're gonna need some custom pixel art. This is a sheath. See it in slow mo. Yeah, this is gonna look pretty good once it's all custom pixel arted. Imagining some sweet little particles and stuff. I don't need that anymore. What's this one? No, we want sheath north. We'll start there. Use this animation to begin. Thank you. Failed. No errors. Xcode 8. Loving it. What? Oh. Slow motion would reveal that the life container itself doesn't look like it's really animated. It just instantly disappears. So does its glow, so does its particles, so does the ring and everything around it. So it would be really nice if it were just, check it out, let's do the slow motion. If it were, would either at least fade out over a 10th of a second, 20th of a second, something like that. Let's do that. Got the energy ID, so we can just fade out the sprite. Should be able to do that. Oh, does it? It doesn't have a reflection component. Oh, let's give every item in the game reflection components. That'll look nice. Ah, that's better. Very right, cool. So, some velocity, the cooldown, the floating power, the other effects. Here we go. It kind of would be cool if it flashed out. So, what's parent? Parents to the render sprite. Okay. It's got an item glow and a sparkle. Both of these we put on the parent, I think. This item glow thing is a sprite. Yep, on its parent. Circle, expanding circles, also a sprite on the parent. Particles are also on the parent. Okay, so we need some kind of animation where it picks up an item. Where does it delete the item? Right. Yeah, we'd do a custom animation for that. Yips. I think the carry already has delete after a moment. And they purported that Xcode 8 was faster. Not while you're streaming, that's for sure. Making videos. Eating up the valuable CPU. Okay, I wonder what it would look like just with a simple delay like that. But then we'll eventually fade stuff out. Okay, so every one of these area delete entity item IDs will become... Right. Okay, let's see what we're doing. Better seeing it not disappear right away. To start with the fades now. Indexing. Wow, that was so slow. Not sure if this will work even. Dude, auto complete. Jesus. Jesus, oh, cool, it worked. Let's see that happen with all its children now. Now it's working. Alright, Xcode 8. Stick away you are now. All right, we got sprites, we got particles. Particles and the sprite. Well, we might as well just try and fade them both, I guess. Shit. Let's do it like this. I don't know if that worked for the particles. I think it probably worked for the glow. It's pretty cool. Yeah, slow mo. Yeah, that worked for everything. That was awesome. Cool. Let's see this with regular time and regular items. What does this look like about that much delay? We'll dial this in for that delay and the other delay and stuff. Let's go here. Birds. What? No items. What game is this? Fire. That is actually pretty nice. Pretty nice, man. Come on, some more items. So we need to immediately, that just gave me like five of those items. So we need to immediately remove the items. The ability for it to be picked up, at least. That would be its collision category. Need item dot. See if that works. Just see, this might ruin what's happening. Back in pickup item. That wouldn't. Yeah, let's just remove this ability to be picked up. I think I'd do that with trample. It spawns an item. There it is, cool down before picking up. Yeah, okay, so it starts with filter none and then just goes filter item. Okay, we're gonna do that instead. Oh, wait, we should also cancel any actions. I think overall Xcode 8 is a little faster with its autocomplete. I am taxing my system here. I wish they would improve the quick open though. There's so much stuff that you don't use in the quick open. It shows you like all the stuff from all so many APIs I'm never ever gonna use. It's like, please just show me the things I want in my own project. I want to quickly open things in my own project, not php.h, which I will never ever open in a C++ game. Alright, let's see this fade out. Yeah, that's pretty good. I think it should fade out a little faster though, by default. Let's try a third of a second, roughly, and then, let's do that first. Jim! Don't pick that up, Jim. Get out of the way, Jim. God damn it. Yeah, third of a second, looking pretty good, but let's try maybe what? Quarter second. Still too long. I think that was pretty good because I didn't really notice it that time, and that's kind of what I wanted this to be, a subconscious thing. Subconsciously, you go like, oh, that was nice. That just happened. You don't really notice it. Consciously. Now what happened there? Like, I don't even see it. It's kind of weird. 0.25 was a nice little fade out. 0.2, it's like it disappeared instantly. Might have. Oh, I guess it is just fading out that fast, huh? Okay, well, a quarter of a second is pretty good then. We'll keep it like that. Let's see this slow. Every detail. Slow-mo. Nice. That was pretty good. Cool. Leaving it. Alright, that's the default. And then when you pick up the item, delete. Remove item. No, not remove item. Courage. Item remove duration equals, say, half the item flux delay. Okay, back to the point where we're getting these little jamblies. Slow-mo. Wow, that wasn't half the duration. Oh, did we already do it? Yeah. I should check on buying items. See it in real time. I'm thinking less. I wanted you to focus on the actual animation that's going on with the character, not necessarily the item behind it. But it does need a little more fade out than the other ones. Pretty good. All right, checking in so far. Wait, one last thing. Buy something. Oh, whoops. What's that look like? Hold on. I have two of them. Dang. Let's save that. Check it in slow-mo. I want to make sure it's not like trying to do any kind of weird fade right before it starts falling or something. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I think it's got custom code anyway. It's not calling it as the other ones are. Just verify that quickly. Purchase the item. Oh yeah, it's got a custom animation going on. Which I'm guessing removes the item. Oh, it's probably not even an actual item. Alright. So far, so good. On to the pixel air. I'm imagining he starts to float up in the air a little bit, and maybe even curls into a ball, and then it kind of explodes into this like crazy animation, and then lots of like particles sucking inwards and then spewing outwards. Sucking and spewing. Give me my graphics template. First thing is the overall timing though. I like that we've got a bunch of frames here. Right, but this part here, this should be kind of extended. We've got one, two. Just two, huh? Three, four. Alright, so I'm going to need to readjust the entire background of the white and everything because of this. So this is the first most important part, is to get the overall, how many frames there should be, and to getting that feeling right. So if I just added 504 frames, one, two, three. I had three frames. So the overall animation before, 12 frames now, so there's 9 frames before. So I just did 12 over 9. Or 9 twelfths. Multiply each frame by to keep it the same. So when the white light shoots out from the sides. That's right when I wanted to him to be in that last pose there. Last frame, or the apex, you could say. Bam! Extra frames. So, let's time that just right. We want a shorter rotate by. Let's take off, start with the 10th. Does it seem like it's even slower? What is going on here? Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm going too far there. Okay, so if there's 12 frames, right, it's like right there is where I want it. So it's the 6th frame, which should be maybe 1.56. Oh wait, no, that's, I mean, it's either the 5th or the 6th. 6 divided by 12. Oh, that's exactly half. Well, that's nice. So I have a little delay in here, so we got... I think that should line up. Okay, so that's 40%, 50%. so it did need to be. Well, not necessarily just 10%. 8% probably would have been more correct. Cool, that's just about right. Yeah, let's see that. See that regular time. Try a little easing on this rotate too. Not exponential. I want it to slow down, so I guess I want sign out. Maybe less rotation. You can do increments of 180, it'd be fine. 360 or 450. Is that right? 450? Yeah. 440? Damn. Pretty cool, actually. Yeah. Okay, wait, that was sign out. What's up? 360. 460. Yes. 440. It's all right. 360. Yeah, 440. I can't add this morning. I've lost my addition. Nah, that's totally wrong. But it was kind of cool, actually. God damn, I can't believe I'm doing this. 360 plus 180. 540, duh. Might actually be cool to randomize this. That was neat seeing that rakish angle. Or I could just start with a random angle. And I'm pretty sure these are all in degrees. Nice. I guess we'll leave it for now. Let's animate. Alright, let's try him flying up in the air a little bit to start with. And then he'll float down as he's doing that pose, so. Okay, what part of it looks stupid? The timings are off for sure. Thinking he should instantly be up high. Must be that. What's a 12th again? Is that 0.08? All right, let's do this math a lot more rock solid. The anim duration, that's cool, but we want just the anim. We can get the total duration from all that. Oh, no, it's okay, so let's go. That is constant. Int. There should be 12 frames total. Just verify all these. Verify the variables. Verify them. Yeah. Okay. Okay. All right. So let's make sure this math is rock solid here. We've got a half, 2.5, that makes 3, 6, 7, 9, 11. Okay, we're missing one. Double check that. A half and 2.5 makes 3, 6, 7, 10, 12. Cool. Now all I gotta do is make sure it's lined up with that one little animation where he jumps in the air. It should look a lot better. And then we'll start doing other stuff. To the pixels. Pixels. Pixels! Like we need one. Oh, and this two here should not be duration times a half. Where does it fade out? I think it's 9. And so we need one more before it does the whew, which is that. So we can delay 4 here. No, what? Oh, less? Where do you go less, huh? It's all right. 3, 5, 6. Okay. There we go. Okay, cool. I don't want to see him floating down so slowly, though. Maybe he's just, like, a little too high. He's too high. Maybe he should get a little higher, actually, as the animation goes. Nah, I kind of like it where he just like snaps. Oh, this is before setting the camera flag. Oh, this needs to be 5. We could do a call funk, actually. Okay, so this is duration per times 10, and this would be a little cleaner, actually. Where to call funk? Maybe 11. Oh my God. The sound effect is really going to help this. You guys are hearing this video and you're like, it's probably not clicking for you. I'm not hearing any audio because I've just got it off for now, but audio will make this just really click, pop. Okay, I think that was right timing. I'm just slowing it down, doing it in slow motion. Let's just check. This is the benefit of being a musician. You understand timing, the importance of timing things just right. Bam. Oh, okay. So yeah, we need a little less. It's an ease exponential duration times two. I don't know if the movies. Can't do derivatives in my head. Kind of eager to get to the pixel art part. The thing I'm noticing here is the reflection part. You can tell I have to, when I put him above everything else and he becomes above this color layer here. Oh yeah, that was about the right timing. It takes away his reflection and his shadow. Just because he's so high above everything. Well, he's actually on a different camera layer. So that's why I'm trying to time it just right so it doesn't even look like he's losing his shadow at all. fact, we might want to do 2.5 there. And 3.5 here. It's good to have all this math solid now based on the actual frames durations. Reflection is good, it's good. Boom, yeah, see? Wait. Wait, did I do this wrong? Oh my god, so lost now. I feel like I'm trying to tune a guitar for the first time. My timing just can't. Does it need to be slower or faster? Okay, if I add more time here. Yeah, no, I don't want to add too much more time here. At most, thinking that. The more time I add there, the later the white is going to go do its effect. Damn, it just doesn't feel right. Doesn't feel right. I'm jumping in the air before it happens. That's better. Okay. I'm just gonna leave it like that. Feels the most right. Cool. We got a lot of good time in here. These are really set up well. Okay, I'm gonna try moving quickly here with something really rough at first, just some black streaks. So I'm doing this really so fast and rough so that I can just gauge whether this is the right move to make before I commit to some really nice detailed pixels. Okay, well, I don't want any on this frame or this frame. And there's a chance I might actually double all these frames, make it faster. Thank you. black was a little too dark. I think in general this is on the right path. I will be right back. Yeah, so this is, I don't know, I'm really not liking this. But, so I'm going to go with this meditation. I'm going to start with these particles, and I'm going to try and do this in reverse, so it looks different than the meditation animation, but looks similar, so because they're both based on his courage, so this might actually make a lot of visual sense to do this one in reverse. We got how many frames here? Two, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Why does it keep changing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, this could look pretty good actually. We take off, that and that. What frame is that? 56.
You want to turn the grill on and I'll get the chicken ready?
I'm doing a video right now.
Okay,
when do you want to do it though?
On the stove.
When do you want? You're just gonna cook it on the stove? Are you sure?
Is that okay?
If you wait a minute, I can help.
Okay, it's fine. I'll wait.
Do you want to do it on the grill though?
Yeah, I mean the grill would make it taste better.
Yeah. Okay, just give me 20 minutes. Thank you.
You can keep working. I turn the grill on.
Okay.
Well, this is looking a lot better than it was just a little bit ago with trying to do some just straight lines going at it. I got some good ideas for how this will eventually proceed. Like, I think I'm going to do a lot less of this maziness here, or else have it kind of come in as a wave. I might try playing around with it going inward or outward. Stuff like that. So I'll probably spend another hour or two just animating, and another, you know, hour making a cool sound and stuff like that. But eventually this will be a really cool thing. It's hoping to just make the really nice epic animation for gaining courage. So that's it for this video. Hope you liked it.